everybody, and today I'm going to show you how I assembled and painted this E-11 Stormtrooper Blaster from Star Wars A New Hope. This was the original design from the first film. As the films have progressed, the design has morphed slightly, but still remaining true to the original.
I started by printing the pieces on an Ender 3 Pro. With the amount of pieces in this build, it did take a long time to print, but as you have seen in the details, it was definitely worth the time. Now's a great time to subscribe to this channel so you can be notified when we release new videos. Once the prints were finished, I smoothed each piece with a 180 grit sandpaper. You want to make sure you remove as much of the print lines as possible. First, I assembled the main body and barrel of the blaster. To do this, I used CA glue. You want to make sure you print two of these C-shaped pieces. They get attached to either end of the barrel. Where the barrel piece is attached, there is a slight ridge of glue. You need to make sure you smooth this to get a nice smooth barrel in the end. To do this, I used 180 grit sandpaper. To attach the ring at the rear of the blaster, I needed to cut away some of the print in order to get it to slip into place. The trigger assembly was put together with CA glue, and then the glue was set with zip kicker before the top piece was put into place. This assembly was then attached to the grip. Make sure to align the trigger assembly precisely. This grip assembly then gets attached to the barrel. Align the forward-facing curve of the grip to this corner of the barrel opening. To attach the grip, I again use CA glue. I attach the wishbone piece to the underside of the blaster with two small Phillips head screws. This whole wishbone piece is meant to be movable so it can unfold into a shoulder support. But I was making this for a family member who only wanted it for display purposes, so I permanently attached the end, which sits against the barrel. I found that it was easier to attach the scope unit separately before attaching the unit to the blaster. Then, on the two L brackets, I glued the block mechanism. Make sure to align this piece so the two small barrels are facing the block mechanism. To attach these barrel rods, you will need to use a little force and bend the pieces in order to make them sit properly in the holes. Just be careful, because if you bend too much, the plastic will break. I used scrap pieces of a thermoplastic to create the connecting coils, but you can also use wire. Then the entire blaster was coated with a filler primer. This will help fill in any of those print line registrations that were missed or you just simply couldn't get to. When the primer had dried, I added layers of a flat black primer. To give the blaster some battle damage, I dry brushed country gray onto many of the edges. This gives the blaster a history, and you the perfect opportunity to create the story behind the blaster. There you have it! A highly detailed E-11 Stormtrooper blaster ready for your next cosplay event, or to display with your collection. If you are enjoying these videos, be sure to give them a thumbs up and subscribe. And remember, if you are building any of my builds or using any of my templates, feel free and tag me at Haas of Props on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok, because I would really like to see your fantastic work. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.